KG from the KG Lifestyle. Yes, I just typed a video about skincare. So if you're interested in that, go check it out. I'll put the link in the description box. However, this video is called the Get My Life Savings Challenge. Now, I'm calling it the Get My Life Savings Challenge because I need to get my life. I know a lot of you, and I mean a lot of you, have
messaged me, Facebooked me, left comments, sent me YouTube messages
about saving money to travel and how I'm able to do all of this traveling and still, you know, meet my responsibilities and things like that. I am not perfect, I will tell you that, but I do love to travel, and I think that our money speaks for what, you know, the things that we care about. So we put, you know, you put your money where your mouth is, and sometimes you can get away from that targeted goal that you have, and I'm here to help myself and help you all to get back on track. I know the summer is full of lots of vacations and things like that, and that's great. It's just I want to make sure that I'm staying and helping you guys to stay on track with your savings goals and your goals in life, okay? I'm a really big follower of Susie Orman. I've been following her for years. I haven't really followed a lot of her advice to the T. So recently, I don't know if it's because I'm about to turn 30 or if I'm like just like having this crisis or something. I don't know. I don't think I'm having a crisis. So I'm just gonna call it Get My Life. I'm just getting my life. And if you are interested in getting your life, stay tuned because I'm gonna give you some tips. In regards to what this is for, it's all up to you. You could be saving for a down payment. You can just be saving in general. You know. A lot of us do not save. You could just be trying to take a trip somewhere. My trip in November, you know, I've done a lot of traveling, but my trip in November was probably the most organized I've ever done. I went to Paris, all over Spain, Morocco. I took 2 weeks off and just lived my life, okay? And you guys can check all of those out. I actually vlogged every single day. Because it was in November and I was doing a November thing. So check my vlog channel out if you're interested in seeing what I was doing and how we were, you know, organized. But we were really organized. We had a website, blah, blah, blah. I'll get into travel stuff. If you guys are interested in that, let me know. I can create, you know, how to organize a trip kind of video. But for budgeting, I'm going to give you guys 3 steps on how to actually get there and add some tips in there as well. So I have my little, you know, organized my thoughts earlier. The first thing you want to do is to create a budget. It's crazy that people, especially in their 20s, do not have a budget. My mom sat me down, and I'm so blessed, and made me do the bills for the family when I was growing up. So she showed me how she budgeted. It's simple. I have a spreadsheet. It's pretty elaborate because it's grown over the years, but you don't need all that. If you want, you can go into Excel and create a simple spreadsheet, but you can also write it down on a napkin, whatever you like. Start with your income up here, that number right there, and then start listing off your expenses. Now, this is a great thing if you've never created a budget, to see where your money's going, and you'll really say, okay, wow, are these all things I need? Like, you know, weekly facials or something like that. Like, you may ask yourself, where is all my money? And you'll be able to see where it is going if you create this budget and do it to a T. At the end, you're gonna have a total of how much you have left, your excess. And hopefully it's not in the negative. If it's in the negative, you need to go back and cut some of those expenses off ASAP, and make sure that you have everything you need. But if you're in the negative every month and you're living paycheck to paycheck, you're not gonna be able to succeed in this challenge, just FYI. So get that together. That is the budget. The budget is critical. Don't even try to do this if you don't have a budget. Write it down, put it in a Word document, put it in an Excel spreadsheet, color code, make it cute. You know, I titled mine my Living the Fabulous Life Budget. You know, whatever you decide to call it, be creative with it if you want. Just make sure your numbers are correct and make sure you have your monthly expenses all listed. The way I have mine set up right now is weekly because I get paid weekly, but you know, you can do your monthly thing too. I actually do have a tab that's for monthly expenses just so I can really see how much is coming in and how much is coming out and then what I should have at the end, you know, if I do everything I'm supposed to be doing. Now, on another sheet of paper, I want you to take your debt. Yes, your debt. That's credit card debt. You know, I don't put my car loan debt on there, but you can put your student loan debt on there. I really just have my credit cards on one separate tab. You could have it on a separate napkin, whatever you like. So just list what your balances are as to date. So today, how much debt do you have? Add that up and look at that number. Let it sink in. It's all right. Just let it sink in. I've been there. I'm still there, girl. Let it sink in. And then I want you to calculate based on what your limit is, what is 20% of your limit. So take 20% of your limit and then compare that to your balance. Your balance is probably higher than 20% of your limit. If so, make a goal as to how you're gonna pay those down to 20%. I mean, it should be lower than 20%, but start at 20% just so you can have a goal. When I look at it, I say to myself, okay, I really want to pay this down now. When you see that number, it irks me. Debt makes me itch like a crackhead. Like, it just, no, I don't like it. So when I see it, it makes me say, okay, I'm not gonna pay just, you know, $20 more than the minimum this month. I'm gonna pay $100 more than the minimum, and I'm just gonna have to cut here and cut here, you know, and leisure things that I have, I'll cut because I want to put a little extra on those credit cards. And that is how you will eventually pay them down. And if you have too many credit cards, cut one up. I just did the other week. Don't be overwhelmed by what you see, but let it sink in so that you can be motivated to make some changes. And that's what this Get My Life challenge is all about. Create a goal. I want to make sure I have that 8-month emergency fund. What is an 8-month emergency fund? According to Susie Orman, she says that everyone should have an 8-month emergency fund, which is liquid cash. You can go to the bank, get it out, and boom, you have that emergency fund. Tires, car maintenance, something happens to your house, you gotta go take a flight somewhere because somebody's in the hospital, like, God forbid that, but things happen. We all know that things happen. So you lose your job. And that's really what she's based this off of. An 8-month emergency fund is all of those expenses totaled times 8. So if you take your expenses, your rent, all of that, and you multiply it times 8, then that's what your emergency fund should be. That's what you should have liquid just sitting there. That and more. You know, you should at least have 8 months. And that's because if you lose your job, you should be able to cover your expenses for at least 8 months, because that's about how long it's going to take you to get a new job. It may be a little less now that the economy's going, you know, kind of coming back, but just FYI, that's where that comes from. So again, that's what I am working towards. I'm not a financial advisor, but I'm letting you know what I'm doing in my life. So pick 3 categories that you're going to start cutting down on in order to fund your future. So you want to fund your future by cutting down on 3 categories. For moi, for the first category, my thing that I'm going to cut down on is eating out. So there's no more in-town food purchases. I'm cooking like all the time. And I love to cook. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that. And if you've seen some of my cooking videos, you know that. But I'm going to make sure that if I'm in town, I am cooking. And I have allowed myself 1 time a week to eat out. That's either dinner or a lunch. So I'm always taking my lunch. I'm always eating dinner at home. That is something I'm going to stick to. And I've given myself an allotted 1 time a week to go out. And I've done this before, so I know I can do it. So that's a suggestion for you. My second thing that I'll be cutting down on is clothing. Especially for the Delta Convention. Ooh. I went ham. Let's just be honest. There were so many sales on New York and Company, and I needed white and red stuff, and I just went and got it. So, to be honest, I probably spent like $100 or $150 in the last 2 months on clothes. But to me, that's a lot because I have so many clothes. So for me, I don't need any more clothes. No more. No more new clothing. If I'm gonna buy something that's clothes or accessories, it has to be thrifted. And it really has to be dirt cheap, like some $2 earrings. Like, it really has to be cheap. So no more new clothing. I'm not going to the mall. There ain't no reason to go to the mall for me. And I know you guys are wondering, whoa, how long is she doing this? Just wait. The third thing is no new travel, unless it's from supplemental income. So I try to keep a travel fund because, as you know, I love to travel. I've already got like 3 trips planned. Those are already planned. The airfare is booked. Most of the hotel stuff is planned. All that is done. I'm not gonna book anything new, and I get itches because I'm a travel fiend to do this, so it's gonna be a challenge for me, but I'm not booking anything else unless I go out and make some money. Now, this does not mean I will be a working woman on the streets. I'm not a working girl. This does not mean I'm gonna go strip down at the strip club real quick to make a couple hundred. This means that I'm going to hustle and do whatever I need to do. I'm a writer, I'm a freelance writer. I could be writing articles. That's my supplemental income. I think all women, especially African American women, should all have something that they're doing outside of their job. Something, even if it's, you know, just being a personal consultant with fashion, if it's helping friends interior design for a couple $100s, like, for real, I think everybody should have a side hustle. So go on ahead, turn your hobby into a side hustle, and you know, fund what you like to do. I like to travel. I'm not gonna dip into my regular pay and my, you know, other things to do those things because I have a goal in mind. And I'm serious about this goal. I wanted to name a couple tips before I tell you how long this is going to be for. Make it rain envelopes. I like to make it rain. Yes, I do. This is a package. This is a package of envelopes. I got it at the post office. My mom taught me this a long time ago. I am horrible when it comes to swiping my debit card. I just think it's an unlimited gift card or something. Like, I just have to use really, really strong discipline when I'm using my debit card. So, my mom taught me a long time ago growing up. I must have been 10. Envelopes. Make it rain envelopes. I mean, she didn't call them make them rain. But I'm calling it make it rain envelopes. What you do is you take an envelope, you get your cash out for your allowance. Now, in your budget, in your expenses, you should definitely have an allowance for yourself. Meaning you know, have something you want to go and do. I probably give myself about $30 a week on allowance. And that's usually not used on food. It could just be something I see at Target. I want a new dress. Or, you know, something like that. Sometimes it's a snack that I love. It's not really going out money because in one sitting you could spend $30. But, you know, just for myself, some allowance. Whatever that amount is, it could be $150 for you. But for me, it's $30. And I take out the cash and this is what I'm going to do. I haven't been doing this. I'm going to put it in here. So this will be labeled allowance. And this is what I'm gonna make it rain with. And you can actually do this with a lot of things. You can say, especially if you have families, you can take out the cash and be like, this is our activity money for the week, for the month. Once it's gone, it's gone. You made it rain. And the rain has dried up and it's gone. Like, it's just gone. So be careful when you use it because it's gonna be gone when it's gone. So you can have several envelopes. Use the envelope system. It's awesome. I definitely think it's a great thing because you see the cash, you're touching the cash, you know what you have, and you know that if you know, you prioritize what you want to do based on what you have. And I think it's a great thing to be visual when it comes to budgeting. So make it rain envelopes, great thing. Coupons! I use the value pack all the time. This came today, so let me go ahead and see. I definitely am a coupon person. Go ahead and get your Sunday paper and clip those coupons and use them, because you can really come up. You can come up with using coupons, especially when it comes to produce and things like that. And a lot of coupons are online now, so check that out as well. I do coupon clip, and what I do is after I clip them, I put them in a little thing like this. I got this at Target in the little like section when you first walk in for like 99 cents. So all of my coupons are in here, and they're just separated. And it's funny because I literally pull this out with no shame. Like, let me see if I got a coupon for that. You know those free underwear you get from Victoria's Secret? That's in here. I make sure to put it in here and put this in my purse so that I forget, like I'm at the mall, I'm like, forgot. I got my little coupon, and you can take your coupon out and get your free underwear and walk out. That's it. That's literally it for the challenge. Now, this is how long I'm gonna be doing it. Till the end of the year. Yeah, till the end of the year. So it's July, end of July, granted. And there's Christmas and all of this stuff coming up. You can budget for those. That could be your goal. Your goal could be our Christmas. This is what you are saving for. You know, again, your goals can all be different, but I'm gonna be doing this at the end of the year. And you can have different goals. You can have different things that you're cutting your spending down on. Don't, you know, if you want, you can copy me and join me in my exact challenge, but make it your own, design it the way you want to, and stick to that budget. Every payday, make sure you're going through those expenses, checking them off as you pay them, whether it's by check or whatever, online, check them off as you pay them. Prioritize based on what you, you know, see coming in and out. You'll really gain a respect for money when you start budgeting. And it's really the best thing ever, budgeting is, because it really makes you look at your life in the way that you're living. And if you're honest with yourself, you'll see that you are spending way more than you need to. And sometimes you're trying to impress people that don't really matter. Let's be honest. Impress yourself. Make your goal and set up these guidelines so that you can get what you want. Who cares if somebody else thinks that the Land Rover is the bee's knees? What if you like, you know, a Pinto? That's probably not true, but okay, a Mustang. You want a Mustang. You don't want a Land Rover. Just because a Land Rover is a, you know, symbol of status doesn't mean that you have to have that. If you want a Mustang, put that on your list and make it happen, ladies. I'm so excited about this challenge. Again, it's till the end of the year. Pray for me. I will pray for you. And I'll definitely do check-ins based on, you know, things that happen and if I have any more tips. Yeah, just let me know. Did you like this video? Do you want more videos about traveling, saving, trip, you know, planning and stuff like that? And I will get it out to you. I know this video is so long, but I hope you enjoyed it. And I'm gonna go now. I want to make sure that I'm staying and helping you guys to stay. And when you have your excess, oh my gosh, what is that? Oh my gosh, I think it's a beaver. I wish I could show you guys. He's chilling. Okay, sorry, there's like a stream or a lake outside of my house. What was I saying? Okay, so I'm going to go and make sure. This beaver thing, I swear.